Hello everyone, once again, this is the Professor, and welcome to another Professor's Anime Reviews, the show where I dissect anime to determine if they are good or not, well, good in my opinion, that is. Today we're going to be looking at one of my favorite animes of all time. This is an anime that I have truly watched multiple times and has yet to get old. I'll let the title sequence introduce it to you. Strawberry Panic is a series that quickly caught my attention after watching the first episode, even though I only knew one thing to expect. Yes. This is a series that revolves around young women learning to love one another in a Catholic-based campus located on Austria Hill. The series was first created as a set of short stories written by Sakurako Kamino. It didn't take too long before this series became popular enough to have a manga created that was localized here in America, plus an anime and video game on the PlayStation 2. Though the anime and video game were never localized for America, so this is an anime you will have no choice but to watch without subtitles turned on. So I hope you love that Japanese dub goodness. The story follows the life of a young girl's first year as a transfer student to the St. Miator House on Hestria Hill. Throughout her year at school, she meets many other young ladies and has a large effect on most of their lives, with some of them falling in love with her and others just learning to rely on her as a very close friend. Yes, this could be considered just another harem anime, which seems to mostly follow a specific pattern, but this one has the obvious difference where it is all Yuri-based, and that unlike series akin to Ranma Half and, say, Rosario plus Vampire, there is a definite decision made by the protagonist. Another large difference is while most harem, as I like to call them, seem to hold a large grasp on the comedic side, Strawberry Panic is more of a serious drama anime. Now, don't get me wrong, there are lighthearted comedic moments in the series, but for the majority of the series, it is a serious drama. Now, the main character's name is Awa Nagisa. She is a spirited young girl who has a large heart and the tendency to worry about others more than herself to the point where she will follow the credo of the needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few to the extent where her own wants and desires get pushed to the side so everyone else will be happy and satisfied. On her first day of school, Nagisa is taken in by the beauty of her surroundings and falls down a hill where she recovers and is met by an unexpected surprise by the name of Shizuma Hanazono, who apparently has the power to put people to sleep by kissing them on the forehead. Nagisa awakens shortly after in the infirmary, where we are introduced to her roommate and soon-to-be best friend, Tamao Suzumi. Suzumi gives Nagisa a tour of the academy and tells her of the Etoile-sama, who is an elected official that represents all three houses in regards to decisions made for the entire campus. This person is elected based on their grace, beauty, and, well, all-around elegance. Nagisa becomes enthralled with meeting her until she finally finds out that the Etoile-sama is none other than the beautiful Shizuma who she met earlier that morning. The series continues from this point to follow Nagisa as she meets other girls and comes to terms with the feelings that she begins to harbor for Shizuma. Though there is another couple that needs to be mentioned, by the names of Hikari Konohana, who is a shy young lady from the St. Spica house, who is a member of the saintly choir, and Amane Otori, who is the star member of the Equestrian Club. Now, early in the series, these two, Hikari and Amane, they are represented with a prince and princess relationship, if you will, where the princess fully understands her feelings towards the prince, though the prince himself is more confused about how he feels, though saying how she feels would be a little bit more accurate, down to the point where even the prince has to save the princess on a couple of different occasions. Though the path of love these two couples make is not so simple. Along their path, there are people who are trying to keep both relationships from growing and coming together, whether it be because of jealousy, personal gains, school status, or even love. Their roads are not easy, and at many times it seems that a happy ending can never be claimed. Now let me tell you, and this is coming straight from the horse's mouth, this is an anime that truly makes you care, and that is the most important factor here. Many shows try to make you care for the characters and fail to do so, whether due to bad writing or bad character development, but Strawberry Panic does not suffer from this flaw. I can tell you personally that there are many times that this particular masterpiece made me want to cry out and do anything I could as long as Nagisa and Hikari got what they desired. Such as near the end of the series where Nagisa is placed in a situation where she must decide between what would be best for Saint Miyator or to be with her beloved Shizuma. Should she forsake those that she cares about the most to be with the one that she loves, or should she do that which would have the greatest benefit for all? There is also this segment that explained the torment and grief that Shizuma constantly deals with. The explanation of her past is one of the most well-written and executed moments I have seen in a long time. This is a segment where I more than likely did shed a tear, and if you don't, then there is something wrong with you. Though the story and writing is not all there is to mention, I must also cover the art style of the series, and this is the only low point behind the anime itself. No, don't get me wrong, it doesn't look bad or anything, and yes, there is a lot of time spent on the backdrops and environments, but altogether, it was lackluster. There was nothing exquisite about it. It simply looks like your average anime. There are times when the animation levels do jump, but for the most part, it is just mediocre. This really is something that gets to me. Strawberry Panic truly is a great anime and a great series, but the animation is on the low end. While there are other shows like, say, Penny and Stocking, which I praise for the animation style, and even Death Note, which I despise, but it blew me away with the animation. I just really wish that there would have been more time and care spent on the animation to truly push this particular show over the edge into perfection. Lastly, the voice acting is amazing, and this is ever more important in a drama anime than in others. In an action anime, they can just scream and yell and you won't know the difference. While in a comedic anime, if the voices sound weird, that is fine because it is meant to be funny. But this is drama, and drama focuses on bringing out emotions. And while animators can do a lot, there is no way for them to truly imitate the expressions made by a human being. So the emotion being captured is done by the voice actors, and this is done perfectly. You can feel the torment, the joy, elation, sadness, fear, and love that is expressed by the characters because of the amazing skills of the voice actors used. I can also credit the soundtrack for helping with this by not only using chorus music, but classical music and piano overtures to set a mood for Astria Hill and the events that are taking place within this year. And it also ends up making one of the most beautiful soundtracks available for an anime out there at this moment. Truly, Strawberry Panic is a great series, and one I highly suggest to anyone who is a fan of anime, and is open-minded enough to say that two young ladies are able to fall in love just as easily as anyone else. This is one that brought me in with the temptation of Yuri action, but it kept me around for everything else. Though if you are expecting a hentai from this series, you will be sorely disappointed. All the action here is rated PG-13, no hardcore action for you or anyone else within Strawberry Panic. This is the Professor, and until we meet again, adieu.